So, just going back to your time in future wrestling, we've done some previous interviews with some other former members. They've mentioned a tour of Europe that you guys did between the first two seasons. Can we talk about that?
Sure. Why not? Do you remember that? I don't think so. Like, that was a long time ago.
I know, but we were talking with Mike, Silver Fox, who said that there was something pretty incredible that happened during it. Could have John said the same thing?
Dude, I'll be honest, I'm drawing a blank here. You're going to have to be a lot more specific.
Sure, well, when we were talking about future wrestling, both mentioned the European tour and something both of them called the car ride from hell.
Car ride from hell? That sounds pretty dramatic. You think we'd have remembered it? Unless it was that time we got stranded at the airport.
Yeah, that's it. They said the flight was cancelled. You guys made it to the next show on time, but they wouldn't really talk about how. They said you guys would remember it more.
Oh, right, now I remember. Yeah, same here. I'll be honest, that tour was a bit of a blur. In a nice way, though. It was a fun couple of weeks.
So, we've heard. Can you talk us through it?
Yeah, I suppose so. Well, this happened just before we flew out to Japan to start with Dream. Yeah, they were wrapping up the first season of this outdoor live show. Lisa got a nice send-off match with Violet Storm. Oh, look at me name-dropping already. Yeah, shame on you, Keith. But, yeah, so we do the show. We're all packed up, ready to fly out. We had the apartment ready, so we figured we'd, like, settle in before I started with Dream. We were pretty much out the door, and then we got a call from Mike. That's Mike Dublin. He did the commentary for the show, but he did, like, all the behind-the-scenes and stuff. He was, like, I suppose you could say he was the talent liaison. Yeah, something like that. Dude wore a lot of hats on the show. That's really true. But yeah, so basically the promoter, Kyle Decker, he struck a deal with some big-time French promoter who was a fan of the product, and he wanted to do a roster for a couple of shows, basically just around Europe for the summer. Pretty good idea, in fairness, when that was like the road trip, but and then we kind of take some bumps. Wait. I did a roll-up in Prague. That counts, right? Sure. Anyway, so we decided to go on it. Well, I did twist your arm a little bit. Just a little. But hey, look, we were all going out on hotels and transports covered, like Keith said. It was a really good deal. That it was. So we all flew out about 2 weeks after season one. Last stand, wasn't it? Yeah. So last stand. So the first night was in Prague. We all got the same flight out. Except for Annie. She was pretty ill at the time. Oh, yeah. Well, she joined up with us in Amsterdam. Prague was awesome, though. Remember when Cyrus pushed you into the fountain? Yeah, I do. And you remember how I got him back? I do, and he hasn't eaten a burrito to this day since. He totally deserved that. But yeah, we hit Prague, and then we went on to Austria, then Budapest. That was one of the hottest days of the summer, too. Like, fucking 33 degrees or something. Yeah, I thought Jerry was going to keel over from exhaustion. I know, and he kept bobbing costume on all day. Astounds me. Yeah, so we're meant to do some shows in Germany, but for some reason they got pushed back. Yeah, can't remember why, though. A couple of days off, and we all end up in Amsterdam, and that's when we met Violet again. Yeah, so we all did the show in Belgium, then there was like two or three in Italy, and then a fucking awesome, they were also fucking awesome by the way, the outdoor show in Venice, Florence even. Yeah, that crowd popped for everyone. Who knew Italians were big Jack Freedom fans? That was when we went to Germany. Yeah, now we had a really good run with the weather all tour, until we hit Germany. Munich went alright, but then the show in Frankfurt wasn't a sellout because of the rain. I'm just glad we were indoors for that one. Tell me about it, that shit was biblical. But we do the show anyway, and it all goes fine. The ring's packed up, and everything shipped out for the next stop in France. I can't remember exactly where it was. Yeah, well, anyway, probably should explain everyone's package was a bit different depending on who you were. So ring crew and producers all had one road show, and then you got your undercard guys, and then the main stars and promoters like Lee Stick, Violet Storm. I remember now. So the ring crew and the guys and girls on the undercard all travelled first, so they set everything up for us. And then anyone who was on the upper tier stayed at the hotels that Decker and the other guys had organised. I think there was about 12 of us in total, something like that. Yeah, I'm probably forgetting somebody, but I think 12 actually sounds about right. Yeah, so like we wake up in the morning, we're meant to get the flight to the airport. I think it's in Cologne, but the weather was back with a vengeance. Like the trucks got a break in the weather and drove overnight to France, but when we woke up the next morning, dude, I have never seen this much rain. Yeah, flights all got cancelled straight away. Like, no chance a plane was taken off in that. Then it's like 6 a.m. and the show's at 6 p.m. So, we're like, we have time to reschedule the flights. But nothing was taken off that day. at all. And, like, it didn't.
Right. So, the story that we've heard is that you guys did make it to the show, and it was reported there was a storyline all night, that there were no top stars in the arena. The crowd was starting to turn, demanding refunds. But it would end up that everyone was getting worked and you guys all came back for the main event.
That's technically true, but it doesn't tell the whole story. Yeah, you tell the story better than I do, Lisa. You go ahead.
So we left the hotel really early on, but we definitely had a feeling that things were not going to plan from the outset. Like, Decker had been spent the entire breakfast on his phone. Yeah, it was a nice breakfast, though. I guess... I don't really remember much of it. Anyway, we get to the coach to the airport, which wasn't too far away, I think. But even then, like, that took, like, an eternity. Yeah, especially when the boys started singing, you know, just to piss you off. Oh, yeah. I actually blocked out how bad they were at that point. They're the worst barbershop quartet, like, in history. Well, anyway, nothing was worse than the weather. Even when we got to the airport, we saw a ton of planes just parked up. Right, so we get to the lobby and we're just seeing cancelled, cancelled, cancelled. And then eventually our flight to France was called off and Decker's phone was going into overdrive. Yeah. We were all in the lobby just watching the weather, like waiting while Decker was just off by himself in a corner.
Excuse me, can I get some napkins? Napkins. Serviette? Thank you.
Well, Decker's getting the tissues out. He's either about to eat that pastry from the hotel, or he's about to burst into tears. I don't know, I think it could be both. He's not a fan of things not going to plan.
Wouldn't blame him if he opened the whiskey early. Not as if we're going to be working tonight.
Ooh, finally going to open up that bottle we got you for your birthday?
You mean the bottle Morris picked out, thinking it was a vintage?
Hey now, how was I supposed to know vintage and cooking oil were the same words in that language?
They're not. You just never learned to read.
Oh, and well done for offending the entire nation of Hungary.
Wouldn't be the first time, Jimmy. Remember Killer Stag Do a couple of years ago?
Is that the second or third marriage?
Third marriage. Old Jimmy got arrested by the Hungarian boys in blue.
Oh, you kept that quiet, young bloods. What'd he do?
Well, it was a long walk from the Irish bar to the hotel, so he took a leak by a statue.
It was some political leader they had once, so the cops locked me up for the night. Killer had to bail me out.
Bail you out? By putting one of them in his hammer lock.
Poor bastard. Still though, out of all the boys to have a criminal record, I would have put my house on J-Man here.
Jones? Please, he's a lover, not a fighter.
Yeah, same way you love all those supplements, Cyrus.
Ooh. Ooh. Wow. Keith, any particular reason why you're staring at the booker?
Huh? I didn't really know, so I was just kind of feeling sorry for him, I guess. Nah, it's his problem at the end. Oh, come on, Lise. This is stressful no matter who you are. You know what? I think he needs a distraction.
Keith, stay here.
Everything all right?
Oh, yeah. Keith's just being himself. Youngblood, you're one of Dicker's friends, right?
Uh-huh.
So, I've had this question on my mind about Decker that I've never gotten an answer to, and truth be told, I haven't really been brave enough to ask him in case he says something that absolutely shatters my trust and belief in him. Keith, how do you know? You know what? I'm just going to go out and say it to everyone. Keith, shut fuck Sticker's favorite movie. Oh.
Wouldn't have a clue, mate. Sorry. So, Lisa, you excited for Japan?
Yeah, I guess so. Got everything ready to go over, like apartment-wise, and promotion's been really nice helping us out. Even then, we've been running around like, wouldn't they say headless chickens? More so like Terminator, right? It can only be that. Or maybe Judgment Day. Anyway, yeah, it's been a pretty wild time.
Yeah, mad to think this tour got organized so soon. Fair play for doing it, though.
Yeah, I like kind of had to, I guess. had some time before, so I started, so, like, I didn't want to come across like a Blade Runner. That dude practically dresses like Harrison Ford. And that guy's name is Decker. Oh my god, that has to be this movie. It has to be. It's Blade Runner, right? Keith, will you just shut the fuck up? Anyway, yeah, I mean, it's good to get a few more, like, matches, like, with the guys and the girls.
It cold?
Get anything good from Duty Free?
Just all of their chocolate. You know, the usual.
Jesus Christ, Annie, you stocked up, didn't you? You're gonna be such a fucking running man. Look, all I'm saying is that he likes something with Arnie in it.
Is Keith alright?
Yeah, he's fine. He's having a conversation with himself for what Decker's favorite movie is.
RoboCop.
Fuck yeah, RoboCop. It's gonna be that one. Probably thinks like his executive is Fred Rosen, just wants to blast him away. Bam! Alex, I love you so much, but please, for the love of God, do not encourage this. Hey, Elise, I need to go to the bar. Do you want anything? No, and the bar is over. God damn it, Keith!
Yeah, Kim? Yeah, it's me again. Yeah, I've got it all written out here. So, run sheet is Mike does the open, get the crowd warmed up, bring him up to speed with what happens. Yeah, openers Carlton and Morocco. Yeah, Carlton going over. Next up is Joyce, Davina, and Dahlia, yeah? Cool. Joyce going over there, Dahlia tapping out. Yeah, yeah. You know that dumbass gimmick Jack was talking about? Yeah, let him run with it. It'll fall on its arse and we'll never speak of it again. Yeah, let him go over against Kevin. Right, I want Connor Locke against Damon Garrick. Give them good time and have Connor go over. Yeah, got all that? Yeah. Main event then is going ahead as planned. Emperor's defend the tag belts in TLC match, but instead of Morphin Violet, it'll be Ratman and Bobbin. Yeah, I bet Tom and Jerry would be really happy with that one.
Hey, Decker. Can't help but notice you're writing match cards on a napkin.
Kim, can you hold on for a minute? Keith, I know you don't notice much at the best of times, but I'm in the middle of something here.
And wrestling is absolutely very important, but...
His favorite movie? Is that really the right time to ask?
As if that's going to stop Key.
Bit late for KO to be looking for a booking, isn't it?
He's asking him what his favourite movie is.
Huh? You know what? Even I don't know that.
I said that too. Not like I'm going to ask him now.
Shh! Okay.
Sounds surprisingly simple.
Don't be so sure, Miss Monroe.
Holy shit, Midas. You've been here all this time?
Yeah, with the newspaper. I just thought you were some business prick waiting on a flight.
Well, I am a business prick waiting for a flight, Cyrus. But yes, Mr. Decker is always quiet when he's angry.
Say nothing. So, how'd it go?
Yeah, well, I won't repeat everything that was said, but it's definitely not Running Man.
You having a fucking laugh?
Oh shit, he heard me. I'm gonna hide in Duty Free.
How the fuck did he get there? He wasn't on the tour!
Jesus Christ, this is something serious.
Right, you need to double check that. Get back to me as soon as you can. Motherfucker!
Everything alright, brother?
Oh yeah, everything's fine. Everything's fucking super. I'm stuck in an airport in torrential rain, all the while my show is in France with sunny skies and a fat greasy son of a bitch is trying to steal my show.
Keith, you can stop hiding. It's not about you.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, apparently Bobbin's trying to steal the show.
It's about time he went postal.
It's not Bobbin. It's much worse. It's Fred fucking Rose.
Wait, so... You're saying the character Fred Rose tried to rebook the show because you guys were stranded. Wasn't he just a tag team manager?
Fred Rose was one real piece of shit. Like, where do I start with the guy?
Yeah, not many people outside Future Wrestling noticed, but Fred Rose was big exec from the VCR network. Like, he was literally the R in VCR. He was that big of a deal.
And he loved sticking his nose into wrestling because he saw it as a nice way of fucking with people's lives.
Yeah, he was a thorn in Decker's side for years. So much more than we realized at the time.
Yeah, he was the one that organized the screw job from the Future Live special.
Yeah, I remember hearing that shoot interview years ago with Liam Hargreaves. I couldn't believe that was a screwjob finish. It looked so real.
It's because it was. Oh, yeah. There was no kayfabe at Rose. Like, he just liked to pull the show into what he wanted whenever he could. Hence, when he heard Decker was stranded in another country with no chance of getting there, he started pulling strings in a big way.
Yeah, for him, it's a golden opportunity. Like, all this stuff from the European tour was being recorded by VCR, so any titles that changed hands, they had to be acknowledged. And seeing we were, like, 3 or 4 dates away from the end, Rose could easily book the title change and fucking disappear with the belt.
This was when Alan Morph was champion, by the way, and Rose didn't like him, so, yeah.
But you mentioned that Alan Morph was with you in the airport. But the match, official match card has him defending his title against Damon Garrick. Is that correct?
In a manner of speaking, yes.
Yeah, so when Decker caught wind that Rose was throwing away his match card, he flipped the fucking lid.
Holy shit, yeah. I've never seen this man pissed off like this. Storming down the lobby up and down, making phone calls left, right and centre. Dude must have racked up 4 figures on the phone bill that day.
Yeah, look, so the thing about Decker is he's very protective about his show. When he was in charge, this was his baby. Worked both ways in a sense. He could run a tight show, but he had to be really obsessive about things. But, I mean, to his credit, it was probably one of those days where caring too much kind of worked.
Yeah, it was a real back against the wall stuff for him. But we were all just standing by watching this play out.
Yeah, but like after a while, we were all getting ready to move. But I'm not sure if we can talk about that part of the story.
Why not? Do you think it's a bit late for the cops to start pressing charges on Decker?
Yeah, I guess. Statute of limitations or such. Okay. So we're on the phone for a while. I hear some of it. He was speaking German pretty well. And then once he hung up, he said he had a way of getting into the venue in Strasbourg. But he needed some volunteers.
Bossman seems to have calmed down a bit. Now what's this about Fred Rolls?
Oh, it's such a long story. And I'll let you know later on. But yeah, like Decker said, this he's gonna fuck everything up for everyone here.
Relax, this is a house show, right? If he does a title change, can't Decker say it doesn't count?
Not quite, Mr. Morgan. I'm afraid the VCR network are noting all of these events as a way of keeping the product relevant during the off season. So I'm afraid everything that goes on this tour counts. Ever find it odd why there's so much production involved for this tour?
Does that mean everyone will see that stinker Morris had the goose shit?
Oh, Jesus, don't remind me. I heard he was as bad as the fucking goal who couldn't even get into a chin knock right. I hope I never work with him again.
Don't worry, mate. I'll put in a good word for you to the gaffer.
You're a good lad, young blood.
Is it safe for me to come out now?
Is there any reason why you're hiding behind a plant?
Yeah. I asked a simple question to someone, and now he's angrily speaking German.
Lisa, you were mentioning about Fred. Alright. Are we all just going to ignore the grown man hiding behind a fern?
At this point, it's actually just best to leave him, like, work this out himself. Why doesn't anyone care about my highly emotional state?
Because a fat evangelist is trying to steal the wrestling equivalent of Christmas.
Well, since you put it that way, Danke. Fern Gunther, you have served me well.
Keith?
Yes, babe.
I know I find you naming plants really funny, but for the love of God, please don't do this in public.
Okay. Can I take Gunther home with us?
This really is not the time for this, and we're kind of in deep shit right now.
Alright. I'll act like an adult, but just this goddamn once. But, Lisa, I will buy you a fucking fern when we're in Japan. Oh, I love you.
I know. Oh, Gart, here comes Decker.
That's the news, brother.
Not good. Kit's been saying that he's after pulling rank with the network and got his way. He wants to strip more for the world title at the top of the show, and I'll give you one fucking guess who he wants to win the belt fight.
What? The people want to see a panda as world champion.
We all do, Alex. Trust me. Unless we do something right now, Damon Garrett is going to be our world champion, and I may very well vomit myself inside out.
Hang on. Why did you sign Garrick if you didn't like him?
As if I had a say on that. If he wanted to get the network deal, the fine print was that the network offered contracts to some wildcards. Wildcards who all happen to be from the same family.
Oh, how incestuous.
Hey, you remember that list of banned words, old man? Yeah, that's on it now.
Yeah, I have a very weird urge to call the police on you.
Wouldn't be the first time Morris got roughed up by foreign police. This time he didn't even have to piss on Comrade Lennon.
Hey, focus, people. Okay, there's some serious shit going down. Alright, let's get a game together. Also, Decker, since when did you learn German?
You know, for a second there, I nearly took you seriously, Keith. To answer your question, I do have a game plan. We're taking back the show.
Yeah! Wait, how? Do you get, like, Pilot Tom Cruise enough to fly us in this weather?
Hardly. No chance of that happening. No, we're gonna make it there ourselves.
We're gonna fly a plane? That's impossible. I know Mike is good in the air, on the air, but, like...
Keith, shut the fuck up about planes. We're not flying anywhere.
I see now. We're gonna go on a magic train that gets us from here to there in 20 minutes, right?
Hang on. Planes, trains, and...
Yes, yes, Steve Martin, John Candy, hilarious. And no, it's not my favorite movie. I hate Christmas. Shut the fuck up.
Technically a Thanksgiving movie, but yeah, go Slay King.
Anyway, I ran the numbers and figured we could get to the show by the main event if we all drove there.
Hang on. Isn't tonight's show in France?
Yeah, Leisure Park out near Strasbourg.
You seriously think we can drive from where we are now to there in what, 3 hours? Come on, man. It nearly took us 4 hours getting here by bus.
Well, that was mostly getting Jones away from the buffet.
Hey, you fuckers don't understand how many calories I need just to keep these guns happy.
You raise a good point, Lewis. There's no chance to make up that distance and that time in rental cars. But it just so happens I know a few people over this part of the world. A few people who just happen to be in a certain club that runs on the Autobahn.
Always an ace up the sleeve, Mr. Decker.
Why is my heart shaking? Mine too. Do we all need, like, CPR or something?
I'd suggest looking out that window.
All we can see are three clouds heading towards us.
But those aren't clouds. That's great. Jesus, Decker. You order Harrier jets or something?
If you ask the right people, these beauties might have more horsepower than the jets.
Ooh, I can see a white one. It's just, it's coming in over the hill.
Is that a black car there? It has these big headlights.
It's a Lexus. Look, the silver car over there. It's a Lexus.
Oh my god, this stage has got a whole lot more exciting. Hang on, it's gone in 60 seconds.
For fuck's sake, Keith, no!
So, let me get this straight. Decker arranges cars for all of you. You all jump in and you start driving in torrential rain to the venue. That's really unbelievable.
Yeah. These weren't your garden variety sedans to get you to the supermarket and back. These were fucking beasts. Decker said that these were things you drive on the Autobahn, and after sitting in one, I can see how. Yeah, I don't know what I was expecting when Decker said he'd arrange transport for us. Okay, well, actually, that's not true. Decker had a bit of a backstage reputation for his driving. He had a real taste for cars, and everyone makes the mistake once riding in the car with him. You never drive with him again.
As in, he was like a dangerous driver.
Dangerous? That doesn't describe it half as much. Man is a demon behind the wheel. Said it to me once, how he unwinds. How can you unwind while driving sideways through every street is beyond me. Same as this. Anyway. We kind of started packing up and just waiting for whatever comes next. Trying to think. He made the calls around 4:30, these cars. And then the show was starting at 6 in France. We're all trying to do the math about getting there. And it wasn't going to work. Yeah, like, with the weather, you'd have been lucky to make it there for midnight, let alone the show itself, like Decker had hoped. But then, the car showed up. Like, all three just, like, heading into the light of the parking lot, and then, oh, they were just so beautiful. I was immediate in love, no offense, Keith. I missed that car. Yeah, no offense taken. But they were works of art. Like, if you told me these things could make it from Germany to France in 90 minutes, I'd fucking believe you.
So, you guys all split up into these cars then?
Yeah. So you had this jet black Mercedes, a white Audi estate car, and a silver Lexus. I pulled Decker aside and I was like, I want that Lexus. And he was cool because he wanted the Mercedes. So we needed a driver for the Audi. And James Rage volunteered. It made sense. Like, Rage was a bit of a nutbag back then too, so he was happy to oblige. So we had our drivers easy enough, but then it was a matter of divvying up the roster into the cars. Violet and Morph immediately ran to us. They got spooked from their last time being in a car driven by Decker. Yeah, so our car was already sorted. The Audi filled up pretty quick too, and then the lads piled together. Rage, Cutter, Jones, Cyrus Gold, Calpier. I think Calpier wasn't there. Wait, what, are you sure? Yeah, remember? I think he flew home after the Amsterdam show. Just, like, left. He didn't tell anyone he was leaving. Oh, yeah. Well, to be fair, he was never really the talkative type of guy, and I was his tag partner for a while. Yeah, he just tended to do his own thing, but he definitely wasn't in Jamie's car. Who the hell was it then? Rage, Cutter, Jones, Cyrus, and... Youngblood! Yes, it was Youngblood who was in the car with him, and Jimmy Morris did a coin flip. Lewis had to ride in Decker's car. Youngblood was a fucker for that one. He had a double-sided coin. Everyone gets caught with him once. You had to buy him a round of shots, remember? Yeah, what a guy. Anyway, so the remainder of the group gets settled in Decker's car, which would have been Rob Midas, Jimmy Morris, and Silver Fox. Probably explains why Mike remembered all this of the car ride from hell. That must have been fun lot to drive with. Yeah. So anyway, it takes us about 20 minutes or so until Decker gets the call on his phone.
Aw, hard luck, Morris.
Fucking hell. You seem to have all the luck, Youngblood.
Ah, don't worry, Morris. You'll ride with us next time. If you survive for next time.
What's that? I'm half deaf in this ear.
Oh, nothing, man. Just checking my emails here.
Alright, so who's stuck for a ride at the minute?
I'm riding shotgun with J-Man here. Absolutely covered.
Thrilled as ever to hear you butcher Highway to Hell again, Jones. Youngblood's riding with us. KO, there's room for one more.
Yeah, not this time, guys. I think I'm going to roll at least this time.
Sorry, what was that, Simon?
Oh, nothing, ma'am. Nothing at all.
Uh-huh, thought so. One more noise like that and you'll be shitting fire for the next 2 weeks. And that goes for the rest of you dorks.
Absolutely agree, ma'am. Mind if I take that seat, fellas?
Always, Cyrus. Anything to save you from the tyranny of dysentery.
Has anyone seen Decker?
Outside, checking his car. I can see him out the window here.
Annie, on the count of three. 1, 2, 3! Jesus! At least warn me before you grab onto us like that. God damn, you small people are shooting for waist loss. Oh, right, I forgot the last time you guys had to get a lift off him. You still haven't recovered yet, huh?
No! I don't even know what hard base is, but I hate it.
What the hell is an initial B? Okay, you guys can drive with us. We promise you a pleasant journey, especially with Captain O'Neill at the helm. Fuck off, I'm driving. Huh? Keith, look at that beauty. It has Celina written all over it.
How? Does it have flannel seats?
Touché, Annie. But come on, Keith. Do you really want to cheat on Shelby like that?
Alright, that's a fair point. Okay, you can take the wheel.
Fucking whipped.
Who the fuck said that? Which one of you dead gym wankers said it?
So, who am I going with?
Well, young Michael, you're going on a magical adventure! Into a wall, perhaps. Or a Bavarian grandmother's front room, maybe. But cool thing, you get to do it with the boss. And isn't that something to tell the grandkids about, eh?
Alright. It doesn't seem all that bad.
All that bad? I'm just lucky I'm insured.
What about you, Midas? You got your ride sorted?
Seems like I'll be catching a lift with Mr. Decker.
Oh, hard luck, buddy.
Yeah, sucks to be you.
You want to maybe switch with me? I have no problem rolling with Decker.
No, not at all. In fact, I'm rather looking forward to it.
Okay, that guy is either crazy or he's completely delusional. I think he's both. That did cross my mind too. Alright, are we all set then?
Alright, I'll give him everything the once over. Stefan says they're all primed and ready to rock. We all decide who we're riding with?
Sorry, Mr. Decker, but I'll be rolling with Celina and Kratos on this one.
Same. Yeah, not doing that again. Sorry, no.
Fair enough, you're a loss. You guys ready to go as well?
Just give the word, boss man.
Alright then, here's your keys. I've sent you all the GPS of the venue, so...
Hey, Decker, is that your phone on the table there?
Huh, so it is. I must have left it here when I stepped out. Four missed calls. I don't recognize the number.
Neither do I.
Nope. Doesn't ring a bell.
Maybe it's Liam Neeson, and he says he's going to find you, and he will kill you.
Shut up. This is Decker. Who's calling?
Gaffer, is that you?
Gaffer? Liam? The fuck did you get this number?
Sorry, mate. Kim gave it to me. She said you lads were stuck at the airport.
Yeah, that's right. We've got a chance to make it back. What's going on over there?
It's weird, mate. That Fred Roosevelt is giving out speeches like they're fucking free Bibles, telling all us jobbers that this is our chance to show the world how good we are and that we don't need the main entertainers that are overrated and overhyped. No offense, lads.
Ah, now I remember why I broke his jaw.
Anyway, some of us here is thinking this sounds weird, so I slunk out during the rehearsal and tried calling you, seeing what the real story is.
Hey, bossman. We might have a buddy after all, huh?
Well, I appreciate the thought, Locke.
Don't mention it, Gaffer. Just thought you'd want to know.
Please, didn't he?
Would suggest we take all the help we can get.
We need to say future wrestling!
Okay, Alex, there's no need to be that dramatic.
Well, it is his title they're taking, and who's talking about being dramatic? Hiding behind plants half an hour ago.
You leave Gunther out of this.
Who the fuck is Gunther?
Gaffer, you still there? Kayla's just been telling me there that Rose is opening doors now.
What?
Motherfucker. Can't wait to get the show rolling. That's an hour earlier than planned.
Figures. I'll be touch and go to make it there.
Come on, mate. We could have done it if the show was ending at 9:30, but not an hour early.
Maybe we need to buy some time?
Hold on. Everyone's gear is in Strasbourg, right?
Think so. Why?
Liam, there's something I need you to do.
Name it, Gaffer. I don't like how this is playing out. It's like a hostile takeover.
Oh, God, sounds so fucking familiar.
All right. Connor Locke, how do you feel about being future world champion for a night?
Oh, it's gimmick infringement. What if he's a better Alan Moth than I am?
Hey, there is only one Alan Morph, except for tonight when there will be a slightly taller one with a Scottish accent.
Is it just me or is anyone else gutted we don't get to see this live?
Oh, same here. Never seen a Scottish panda before.
They may take our bamboo, but they'll never take our freedom!
Lisa, what if it's... No, it's not. Just get in the fucking car now, Keith.
Alright, Liam, put Sonny on. Hey, Sonny, remember me? It's your boss. Your actual boss, not the fat ass that paid you off a couple of months ago. Yeah, I thought as much. I don't care what Rose says. I want every match to go plus 10 minutes tonight. Give them as many spots as they want. I don't care. You keep the show going no matter what. You hear me? Good. We back on to Liam.
You all sorted, Gaffer?
Yeah, we're about to move now. You think you can handle this?
Pressure makes diamonds, mate. Leave her with me.
Fucky little shit, isn't he?
I can't believe we're trusting all of this to a wet behind the ears trainee.
You would have preferred we had a wet behind the ears nepotist as world champion?
Why do you have to be so intelligent, Midas? Must get tiring after a while.
Any conversation with you, Morris, is tiring. I fully intend on napping through this drive.
Good luck with that. I didn't sleep for 3 days after last time.
All right, Locke. Good luck. Who knows? I'll be pushing it for you if this all works out.
I'll hold you to that, Gaffer.
All right. What are you waiting for, people? Let's move out. Ah, listen to that beauty.
Oh. That's louder than I was expecting.
Seats are comfy, though. Why am I sitting in the back anyway?
I'm sitting here instead. Respect your elders, Jim. My poor old legs need the room.
Since when have you been older than me?
Clearly, you put years of me whenever we speak, Morris.
You keep walking into that one, Jim.
It's fucking bollocks.
You all finished yet? Oh, you might want to use those extra belts. I feel like arriving early.
Oh, Keith, I am in heaven! Fucking no kidding, this car is a car sitting in, or is it just a fucking goddamn spaceship?
Ooh, the seats line up too! We picked the right car this time!
I know we did. Lisa's a good driver. We won't be stuck to the windows this time.
Yeah! Relax, guys. I won't be pushing this baby. We are gonna cruise along and get there in our own pace. Nice. Will I get the playlist up still?
How else are we gonna make this road trip go by?
It's girls!
That's exactly what's on our playlist.
Fuck's sake, Jones. I can hear the car buckling under your weight.
Would you rather sit in the back? Is that going to affect your driving performance, Mr. fucking Schumacher?
I'd rather you didn't eat so much, so that the wheels don't fly off and we end up Fred Flintstoning our way out there.
We've got space here, Jones, if you need it. Hell, Youngblood is only a skinny lad anyway.
Yeah, don't live in the gym like you guys. How's your driving, Rage?
Well, I passed the license. Although, I've always been more of a bike man myself.
Bit young for the midlife crisis, aren't you?
Dunno, mate. You've already had about 3 of them. You tell me.
Yeah, Youngblood is meant to be an ironic name, right?
Absolutely. Same way you've never seen a championship in your life.
Boom! That's why you're in this car, Youngblood.
All right, are we all patched in?
Coming over loud and clear, boss.
This is Kratos Wood, Houston. You're breaking up. We can't quite hear you. Houston, we have it. Give me that fucking man-child. Yeah, we're all here all right, though. Especially Keith. Sorry, guys. I'm just excited. I've never seen a car with gears on the steering wheel before.
Neither have I. Must be a new thing.
New thing? Fuck's sake, lads. What rust buckets have you been driving?
Well, I don't drive for a start.
What? How do you make towns? Don't tell me you've been hitching rides for all your career.
I can vouch for Morris here. Yes, he has. Every day of his life.
Fuck off, you. At least I pay for the diesel money. Anyway, got a lot of ground to travel, and if Locke holds up on his side, we've got until 9:30 to reach the venue. Stick close, and we all get there with time to spare.
I just want to be clear here, Adam. We're not racing here, all right?
Yeah, I'm lugging around way too much mass to be keeping up with you.
Are you fucking calling me fat again? I swear to fucking God I will let off a fart so nuclear that your goddamn fucking face will melt.
Uh-huh. Tell you what, whoever gets there first gets a title shot next show. Deal?
Wait, what?
Title shot?
See you all on the other side.
Decker, wait up, for fuck's sake. Oh, you do not just drive off on me like that. Holy shit.
All right, boys, let's fucking move.
Stop like that.
loving this.
Decker?
Yeah?
Does the car really go faster than you're driving sideways like this?
No, it makes climbing hills more fun.
I beg to fucking differ.
Oh, don't be such a wet wipe, Morris. Seatbelts are here for a reason.
I don't know who you're fooling by this. You're sweating bullets as high as I am.
It's called adrenaline, Morris.
Please, you're not seriously about catching up with Decker, are you? Heath, if Adam is giving it a title shot, I'm taking one. That motherfucker owes me one as it is. That's great and all, but what? Well, there are three other people in the car, and we would all like to, you know, just not die just so you can be a world champ, okay?
What's worse, Damien Garrick as world champion, or losing a race to Decker?
Do you even need to answer that question?
Well, at least, let's just slow down a bit, okay? Maybe drive like those children in the... Children! They're adults!
We're all God's children!
For fuck's sake, I can barely steer this fucking car.
Just the way, like you said, sir.
The wrong way. You keep going the opposite of what I want.
Do you know how cars work? Andy, look, this is too confusing. Okay, I'm just going to get the playlist working.
Real workhorse that, Cutter Jones.
Yeah, surprised that didn't gas him out.
I remember that fucking nuke I'm holding in. Yeah, not another word out of you.
Maybe if you crack open that back window, Cutter can give us a little turbo boost.
As dumb as that sounds, that might actually give me a chance to catch up.
Nope. Not moving. I call shotgun on all road trips.
Yeah. Here, Lewis. What if we ditch Cutter? We could say the car would be easier to drive.
Well, for one, I'll be able to turn the fucking thing, so yeah.
Yeah, maybe if you bothered working out your arms once in a while. And if you leave me here, I'll call Lisa and say that you were the one that put the whip in Kratos' bag back in Milan.
Bullshit! Bullshit! That was Youngblood.
You sure? I mean, it was so long ago. Could have been anyone.
So we're agreed. No one gets dumped to the roadside, right?
Agreed. Or else I'd never hear the fucking end of it.
Hey guys, hold up back there. Tumble dryer full of spuds. Cheers, boss.
Sounds like they need a break, Mr. Deck. You'll
probably do it one yourself.
Perhaps. Tell me, how fast do you think this machine can go?
Yeah, I'm trying. Over this hill, yeah? Oh, sweet Jesus, that tree there had my fucking name on it.
Don't know, I'm hoping to aim for the ditch around it.
Oh, listen to that.
Simply lovely.
Jesus, I can hear Dicker's car from here. Can't see him though from all the rain. Still, he's probably showing off to his passengers. I mean, he wouldn't do that, right?
Mm-mm. You literally have not stopped talking about this car since we left.
Come on, Andy, we're riding in style here. I've got so many buttons on the dash, I've no idea what to do with any of them.
It's the one for us to go to sleep and we can wake up at the show. I keep clicking my heels, but nothing's working.
You need red shoes for that, Alex. Or a small dog. We've got neither.
Oh, yeah. You better believe we aren't in Kansas anymore now, Morph. This is Celina country. Check this. Some sunny day, oh, nice. I see some rear lights in the distance right there. Yep, that's Decker.
Nicely done. Now can we slow down, please?
I don't want anyone to have any more title shots. I just want my title back.
Oh, Ellen. Well, heart goes out for you, buddy. It's not fair what's happened to you. But look where we are now. We're on our way to saving the day with a car that has 8 fucking gears. 8 gears, Alan. This is space age shit right here. I mean, look, this car even has a red button that's clearly a nitro. Keith, what the fuck?
So anyway, I say to Killer that we gotta leave him behind because he's in serious shit with the cops. But Killer, quick as anything, says, then I'll just get in more shit with the cops. And he'll probably kick the door down and try to break Morris out.
Fucking hell. Boy, am I glad I never ended up training with Killer. Guy sounds like a proper fucking psycho.
Yeah. What a role model he is.
Didn't KO say that he was a trainee at Killer's Academy?
No. When you say a trainee...
Whoa, shit!
Fucking hell. Is that Lisa's car?
Yep. Looks like she's lost control of it.
Everything right back there? I'm seeing Lisa's GPS go static there.
Guys, please don't make any women driver's jokes. That could literally kill me.
No promises.
Yeah, we're fine. Just a bit of confusion here.
Hey, what kind of genius makes a handbrake a fucking big red button? Stupid Americans are 8-geared behemoths. It's bullshit.
Uh-huh. Well, follow us along as best you can. We're making some good time here, but we're hitting some pretty dense forests.
Behind you, boss.
So, Decker, while we're reversing out of this ditch, what's your opinion on Nicolas Cage?
I don't have one.
Damn, that knocks at least 5 of my guesses.
Keith, give me the fucking phone.
Ah, so that explains why there was an Alan Moore from the cart that night.
Yeah, exactly. Liam Connors, how we knew him at the time, he just this little Scottish kid who looked the part, but he just needed the experience and a big break. Decker saw something in him, and thankfully he was at the show as part of the undercard, so he kept us all up to speed on what was going on. Not gonna lie, having Connor Lott dress up as Alan Morph was a stroke of fucking genius.
Yeah, just a double check here. Connor Lott, as in New Sopotsu's Connor Wraith, once wrestled as Alan Morph.
Yeah, it's absolutely crazy, but it's the honest truth. I would say that Connor would confirm it himself, but yeah, I don't think he'd be wanting to hear that go viral on him.
Oh god, yeah, his reputation as the big bad demon of Japanese wrestling would take quite a hit if people knew he once dressed up as a fucking panda.
Still though, he was future world champion for a night.
That's true, first of many titles.
Okay, so, getting back to the story, how much of the show in Strasbourg were you aware of as it was going on?
Well, whenever it was quiet on the road, Decker would keep us posted on what was going on, but as far as I know, he improvised match cards wasn't changed that much, except for the main event.
Yeah, like, Decker had his routine on tour where the titles were defended on alternate nights, so one night was the world title, then the next night was the tag belts, kind of kept everyone fresh that way. Strasbourg was the night for the tag titles. He wanted this cool TLC match, but I think Rose tore that up, and I think he, like, tried to stay top of the show that it was going to be, like, the world title was vacated. That was when Connor Locke came out as Alan Morph and completely off the cuff. Like he just cut this amazing promo with Rose, and then that was the main event with him and Dave McGarrick. Yeah, I generally think Fred Rose believed that was the real Alan Morph that entire night, and he just jumped the gun. But knowing him, he probably figured out he could screw Alan out of the belt. Anyway, and pull off the heist one way or the other.
Right. So as far as I know, Connor was Decker's man on the ground, and he basically told anyone on the match card to go overtime. So the longer the show went on, the better it was for us.
Yeah, like, the weather wasn't easing up and heading into some really dense forest, so we kind of needed all the help we could get.
And do you know if the people on the undercard were happy to go along with this?
Kinda. Like, you have to understand, in wrestling, opportunities like this don't come around very often. And if you end up in the main event, you need to make the most out of it. I was talking to some of the girls afterwards, and they did mention Rose had done these speeches before bell time, and that managed to get them all on side.
Only after a few of us knew the real Fred Rose, everyone else just saw the guy who lived his own gimmick. So you kind of took it for granted for his charisma and personality.
Yeah, that's just it. Like, if you're one of them, you wouldn't have known half the cloak and dagger shit that was going on around. But yeah, Rose had them ready to go, and Connor played along saying Decker was going to give them all the time in the world to just get themselves over.
What a charitable guy.
Yeah, so I heard the opener actually went on for like 20 minutes.
And that was the fucking shortest match of the night. Those fans must have been catatonic by the main event.
Actually, I don't remember what the match card was. Have you actually got it there?
Yeah, I do actually. So, the show starts with...
Been pretty dark out here, Lise.
I know. I'm gonna take it a bit slower around here, especially with all these trees.
In fairness, it does look like we're doing pretty good for time.
Yeah, here's hoping those guys are really enjoying the limelight, having poured those people to tears.
The one time when a pal doesn't want them to fight forever.
Be careful what you wish for. Might just happen.
Curtin's ever wrestled for 20 minutes before.
Curtin's?
Carlton. Some of the boys nickname him Curtin's because he keeps opening the show on our tours.
I reckon Decker's doing it for a joke now.
Ah, totally. He's probably hoping that he'll get Titus over or something.
Hey guys, isn't it great not to be driving with Decker right now?
Yeah, can only imagine how stressful it is in that car.
The loud music, the engine screaming, the tires screeching for mercy.
You can see the appeal, can't you?
Maybe you could then, but I'd rather cruise along with Shelby.
Same here. Which gears did you say didn't work with Shelby again?
All the even ones. Number ones even. You'll know from the smell of burnt rubber.
Okay. Take bets, guys. Which one do you think is having the worst time in that car?
Jimmy Morris. Probably saying a rosary as we speak.
I can totally see that happening.
No. Someone tells me that Fox is the worst off. I have this mental image of him passed out from the nerves and just loping around.
Nah, I hope not. I like Mike. What about you, Lise?
I don't know. I'm kind of focusing on the road myself.
I think we're all forgetting Rob Mice in that car as well, right? Like, how old is that guy?
Like mid-40s, I guess?
Pretty old for a wrestler.
He's not a wrestler.
True, but still, his old ticker might not be able to take those drifts and spins.
Now, I must say, it's a very good read if you've got the time for it.
Nah, I'm sure it is. I just wasn't aware he read the book.
I know, it doesn't sound like something he'd do. It's a fascinating collection of stories. Very much one for the historians.
Yeah, you say a lot about Killer, but he wasn't fucking boring.
That he wasn't. And I understand that that Go Takumi is publishing a memoir soon.
Is he now? I'd very much like to read that.
Well, I'll see if I can catch wind of an advance on it. I'd say there are quite a few tales on that one.
Oh, for sure. I wonder, does he mention the shoot he had with Kenzo Fujinami?
I suspect things might be still quite sensitive. After all, Kenzo did found new Sapatsu only for Go to buy him out.
Out? Kenzo was dying at the time. That was only doing what he was right to keep the promotion alive.
Well, Go may say that, but I'm sure Kenzo's estate says otherwise. I hear they still don't get any royalties.
I'll have to take your word on that one. You guys doing alright back there?
Oh yeah, no bother, boss. Just writing my fucking obituary over here. Here lies Jimmy Morris, beloved husband and father of one. Made the foolish decision to jump into the wrong fucking car, and apparently the right answer was to sit at the airport and get pissed at the airport bear.
I have no doubt you'd have been ushered off the premises at that point.
Can you at least appreciate I made my final words rhyme?
No.
As weird as it sounds, I'm starting to get used to the whole death around every corner thing. It's like I know I'm gonna die, but just don't know when.
Cheers, Mike, for killing the mood. Is it just me or is Jamie's car drunk off the grid?
Let me get my glasses here. Yes, it does seem like he's pulled up. Shall we give him a call?
Yeah, no harm in checking. Hey Lewis, has your GPS gone off or have you parked up?
Afraid so, boss. We have a slight medical emergency on our hands.
Emergency? What's wrong?
You know when a 5-year-old gets car sick and it's really inconvenient?
There you go. I have to press the speaker button.
Thanks to IT Helpline. Sorry guys, what did I miss?
You know when you've had the most glorious bottle of whiskey, but it's so good, you've realized the whole bottle's gone. And then your stomach needs to get pumped.
Yeah, you lads finished with the metaphors yet? You all gotta tell me what's gonna happen.
Mr. Jones is car sick. And I mean fucking car sick.
I'm all right. I'm just... Oh, still some air.
Jones, how much did you fucking eat? We've been here for 10 minutes.
Fine. Honestly, I didn't even want to be champion.
Well... I'm sorry. There's something about driving at high speed and going side to side doesn't agree.
I had to sympathize. Big Chief.
This is fucking embarrassing. No wonder you never did tequila with us.
Oh, Christ. That's just pure acid now. That grass will never grow again.
At least we'll know where it is if we ever tour again. Maybe return with a ceremonial plaque.
Look, you guys work away there, but get cracking whenever you're ready. It's getting pretty marginal on time. I need everyone there to do the show work out.
That reminds me. You never actually said what we were going to do when we get there.
I'm still working on it.
I thought you always had a plan, Decker. Like Michael Caine in that friend job.
It's the Italian job, you philistine.
Ha! You fell into my trap. You're a fan of the classics. Okay, let's start with 60.
Yeah, fuck off. I'm hanging up now.
Right. Are you done scorching the earth, Jones? We're behind enough as it is.
Well, I'm fucking sorry that my health was such a great inconvenience to you, Lewis. At least now I'm all anorexic and shit so you can drive faster.
That weather is awful. Did I really have to stand by and give you moral support?
Yes. And it was very appreciated. All right. I'm back in the saddle. I'm ready to go.
And I know exactly what we can do to get us back in the mood. Check this out.
The fuck is that?
Holy shit, is that an actual iPod?
Fucking hell. I haven't seen one of them since I was 10.
Nathan, I know you're a dinosaur as it is, but please don't say that that's yours.
No, it's not. But it does belong to one Jim E. Morris.
Oh my fucking god.
Lads, plug it in. We need to hear what that man listens to.
Fiverr says it's nothing but rebel songs.
Yeah.
If the Spice Girls start playing, I can die a happy man. Christ, this is so much worse than I imagined.
Peak boomer music. It was Why didn't you see this coming?
And this is first up. This isn't even put on ironically.
Oh, lad. No, no. Can't take this. Have to go again.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Fucking Morris.
How's
it going, Liam? Going alright, mate. I managed to derail Fat Freddy's promo quite well by just being myself, or being Morph Self. See what I did there?
Gimmick infringement!
I let him away with that one, Alan. That was actually pretty clever wordplay.
Oh, yeah? Well, I think we should lock him up for thievery.
God damn it, that was pretty good, too. Don't make me choose between the two of you.
As I was saying, what match is on now?
Well, the two lads cut that backstage promo like you said, and Jack just stung the place out of his fake accent and ate up some time. I'm hiding out in Gorilla here, but it looks like they're doing the tag team match now.
Oh, I do love some TLC, and not the chasing waterfalls type.
Just you stick the rivers to you, stick.
Boom.
Right, this is working out well. We seem to make up time for the main event. We'll keep in touch, lad.
No bother, Gaffer. It's starting to get warm in his get up. Haven't had to play mascot since that internship at Aberdeen.
Only us trained actors can do that, lot.
Hey, I did a GCSE on acting. Didn't pass it though. That Shakespeare guy is fucking overrated.
Kids these days.
Anyway, I can see Rose skulking around. Have to act the part. See you soon, though.
Hey, that's my line. Yeah, but
he says it so well.
Hang on. You saying that wasn't Morgan talking there? I need to get my ears checked again.
Quite a handy touch you can do for that, you know.
Oh yeah, anything to avoid those fucking GP fees.
Well, what you do is, take a flashlight or something like that, stand yourself up by a wall, shine a light through one ear, and see if anything shines on the wall through the other.
Yeah, heard that works out a treat.
Ah, you're already a fucking bollocks, Midas. Can't have a proper conversation around you, good on.
Then don't.
Hey, Deck, are you still on the line? Looks like Jamie's car is back on the move in a big way.
So he is. Catch him in. We'll hand it into this corner, yeah? Never in there. Lewis, I see you're back in the chase.
That we are, boss. They found a solution to Cutter's car sickness.
Is that fucking him again? How does that have a car sickness?
Because there's more room for the rest of us.
An old man like me needs the leg. You can lie down and feel every bone.
Oh, did I fucking love being punched in the fucking neck of a fucking knife, a fucking car?
Who is fucking behind anyway? Too far. We need to make up at least half an hour somehow. Those two cars are way ahead of us.
Don't suppose I can play the iPod again?
No. And if you do, I'll fuck it out the window and play Morris and pop our taste in music myself.
Was that me you were talking about there?
Nah, mate, it's his great uncle Maurice. He's a pianist by trade.
Oh, what? We don't allow perverts to stay in the family like that.
What? No, as in someone who plays the...
Shit, aquaplaning.
Hey, Liggs!
Oh, that sounds like someone's had a bad crash.
Lewis? You still there?
Yeah, just about. Skidded off course, but we're still moving. This thing is a fucking monster.
Well, you picked the Audi. That thing is four-wheel drive. Won't do any terrain, any weather.
Nope. Not jealous at all.
I like new Shelby the way she is. Stupid red button and all.
Oh shit. I thought we were hitting that mound, but the thing handled better on grass than it does on the road.
Well, I'm glad you're all having fun, because I'm being thrown around like a dog's toy here. My bowels aren't empty. As it is, this can't be a lot less white than it is now.
You do provide the nicest mental images, don't you, Jones?
Is that why I'm in the booth? To turn this into a splash zone?
Well, we don't exactly have to pay a deposit back on this car, do we?
No, but I'd rather not have a group of German street racers pissed off at us for soiling one of their soccer mom's cars.
Hang on.
Why are we slowing down?
Simon, pass me the phone.
What's the matter?
Nothing. Need to check something real quick. Yes. Okay, we can make this work.
Make what work?
Hang on, lads. We're about to take one massive fucking shortcut.
I fucking hate you, James Lewis.
So that's the plan. We all come in hot into the venue, change the main event to a rumble. Everyone jumps in, we call an audible on the winner. Need to give that crowd something that won't end up being a bitch fest on the forum somewhere.
Yeah, I like the sound of that. Did the other guys know?
I told Youngblood when Jones was having his toilet break. He'll bring the lads up to speed.
And Locke and Garrick are on board with us?
Locke is. Wouldn't give two shits what Garrick thinks, but he's an idiot. He'll play along.
Hey, you think there could be space for one really buff boyfriend of a wrestler?
Sure, why not? Not this show could get any worse.
Sweet. Morris, I promise I'm not going to throw you out first.
Gladly. I just want to go home and not have every everything fucking spinning around me.
Is this a good time to mention that I've been wrestling training? Perhaps I should put those lessons to good use.
No offense, but aren't you a bit old to be wrestling, Rob?
Never too old to live out a dream. Isn't that what they say?
Can you do any flips?
No. I leave that to the experts. Like yourself, Fox.
Well, everything starts off in the Battle Royal eventually. I guess it'll be your debut, Midas.
Extra incentive to get there now, isn't it?
Speaking of incentive, what's up, Decker?
You my rear view, Lise.
Who else has become one of your arse legs?
You're gonna be that desperate for a title shot.
Well, I caught up, didn't I? And a promise is a promise.
But you did. You have to get there first. It's near straight run down to France. Think you can keep up?
You're with me thinking we'd have an easier time.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Shut up, the two of you. You're on, Booker, man.
Guess I'll take the handbrake off then. Okay, so at what time did you arrive in France?
I think it was just after 9. We were like a little bit separate at this point, thanks to me being a dumbass and Cutter getting carsick. Decker was leading the way. Dude was like pushing, like he was pushing like hell to get there before the main event. Locke and Garrick were heading on to the ring at 9:15 local time, so we had 10 or 15 minutes to get there. Well, we assumed so, because we had like no idea what kind of the shit Rose was going through, was going to be pulling like once we got hit France, so we were pushing like crazy. Yeah, me and Decker were more or less on the same stretch of road. Somehow Jamie's car caught up to us. And thank God it had finally stopped raining at this point, so it kind of really helped us out. Yeah, man, it was a real sprint to the end. Thank fuck for a quiet night, otherwise we would have been pulled over. Or worse. Yeah, we were seriously lucky that night. Like, I know we shouldn't say it, but it was a hell of a rush driving like that all night, and I can kind of see why Decker does it. Well, timed up. Oh God, Jesus, no, like, I don't have an actual death wish, like...
So, as I was saying earlier, the main event ended up being an impromptu battle royal. This sent the crowd unhappy. Was there any point where that was planned out?
It really depends on what you mean by planned out. Locke told Decker to let the referee, who was Sonny at the time, that we were like on the way and just to keep the match going no matter what Fred Rose said. Okay, so like bear in mind now that like Sonny was on a warning over the stunt that he pulled with Rose the last time. So he took another bribe and he was out of there. Yeah, so he should have been fired, I think, the first time. But Decker had his reasons. I don't know what they were. Yeah, well, like, at the point we realized we were going to make it in time, Decker told each of us that we were coming in hot, straight into the arena. No bullshit, no entrance. We literally just hijacked the show and say that we're doing a rumble for tonight only because the fans were so awesome or some bullshit. Nothing about a rumble was planned. Locke just told the crew to come out when we did and let everything break down to a massive brawl until Decker arrived and made the match official. Locke must have been gassed out, like, just from telling the crew what was going on. Like, he was a real star tonight. Oh, yeah, totally, for sure. But then, the entire Rumble was called completely on the spot, winner and everything. It was the most fucking beautiful chaos you've ever seen. Yeah, 3 hours of adrenaline really gets you in the mood for wrestling. Oh man, I fucking crashed so hard that night, it was insane. And you crazy motherfuckers went out for drinks after that. Dude, the place had a Ferris wheel. Me and Annie weren't letting go of that opportunity.
Just getting back to the question there, can you talk us through what happened in that main event?
Oh, right, yeah, sorry, we just turned off into this country road and then my foot hit the floor and then we got close to the venue.
And the avenue, friends, and look, it's that green.
Yeah, that's nice. I'm gonna call Liam. Liam, what's going on?
All good here, Gaffer. They're just cleaning up after a TLC match now. Didn't realise you had all that sorted away for tonight.
Yeah, well, it was the last of the rest of the tour, but fuck it, it's all recyclable. You guys up next to take it?
Aye. Derek's going out first. Rose is out with him. Tubby, fall back.
Tell us how you really feel there, Liam.
You've no idea what it's like here, Annie. He just keeps winding people up here and saying Decker doesn't like them and shit like that. The fella thinks he's running the show, but we're going to prove him wrong.
As much as they don't like you, be me for a night, I believe in you, Connor Locke.
Oh, Helen, you really are the champion of our hearts.
As touching that all is, we still have a job to do. Liam, keep that match going for as long as you can.
Will do, Gaffer. I'll be setting records for the number of chin locks in one match by the end of this.
Alright, people, last stretch of road. We all ready for this?
Yes. What about Jamie's car? Didn't you say we need them to make the rumble happen?
Ruining us out too early.
How are you back in ring already?
Well, let's just say we made a detour. We found some quite nice farmland to play through.
It was fucking right. Jamie's hit more fucking rocks and ditches. I'm surprised the car's still even moving.
Fuck the car! What about me? I'm standing boat!
Good. You can vomit on Fred Rose when we get there.
You're a sick man, young blood. But I like that idea. So Decker, by my maths, we should be caught up to you in about 5 minutes. Not bad, eh?
Yeah, not bad. Car better be intact, though.
I'm just told this new racer dude to be hit a car or something.
In fairness, we did come pretty close to clearing out of Locke.
My black and white brethren will not be happy about this.
Well, you haven't dressed up as a cow for a match, have you?
Getting low
floated
most times is not fun.
Oh yeah, I had a match like that once. Got well paid for it though.
Didn't tell way too much information, Morris.
Alright people, listen up. The main event is happening right now. It could be at any stage when we arrive. The rule is to come in straight into the arena and take the show back. Give Rose no chance to reply or respond. Once we're all in the ring, it's a free-for-all. I don't give a shit who wins, so send that crowd home happy.
And as men, how do you deal with Rose and his cronies?
We don't. Rose is still away like he always does. We do a free autograph session and something at the end.
Sounds good to me. You think anyone will ever believe us if we told him this story?
Not a chance. But give it to yourself. Got main roads from now until the venue, so put the pedals down and don't stop for anything.
Come on, Kerr. We're the next boss. We've caught up.
Well, that's right. On fresh people, let's do this. one more burn at, for all time's sake.
Aren't we on a bit of a schedule here?
We've not seen the lights and sound show, Morris. We've clearly arrived.
Oh, nice of Adam to tell us where he's going with the smoke signals.
At least he hasn't set anything on fire. Yes.
He needs to be staying at 88 miles per hour for that.
Because we're going back to the future wrestling?
Please, Adam said the thing. This would be great. Keith, I'm driving. And look, that's the Ferris wheel.
Oh, we are so trying that out. And I brought the gin with me.
This is cool. You always pack the essentials.
Right then. I guess we follow this road down to the venue. Decker said it's some sort of entertainment area.
Well, that big fucking Ferris wheel and beach. Bit of giveaway.
Ooh, a beach party. Sounds like fun. Can we get Jimmy drunk again so he can start rambling about politics and how his Mickey used to work?
No fucking chance. I was up until 5 a.m. the last time you did that. Fucking hell.
Here, Decker. Where's the road from the venue?
We have to go the long way around. I mean, we've got no time to lose.
Adam, slow down. We have brakes for a reason.
You say that. I just used the dirt to slow this.
You know, that was really fast and furious. Hang on!
Took you long enough, Keith.
Okay, I think that's everything covered. I'll just stop recording now. Right. Okay, that was really good, guys. Thanks for agreeing to do this. It was great hearing some of those stories.
Yeah, no problem. It was nice to reminisce for a while. Yeah, stuff I totally forgot about until you brought it up. I know, right? Like, what's going on, like, back at the archives of us wrestlers?
I know. See, Hargreaves asked us to do a couple of sit-down shoots with some of the future wrestling alumni, for obvious reasons. And we already had gotten the Youngblood Brothers a while ago. And Nathan said that you might be up for chatting about things. And we managed to get Cutter Jones last week, so that was a pretty big get.
Yeah, he must have been talking for days about his fucking stories.
Yeah, went very over time. I still need to do the edit and legal on that, so... anyway, I'll get all this into the car and I'll call him while I'm out there. I'll be back to pick up the camera and stuff in a bit.
Okay, no problem. That wasn't too bad. Yeah, crazy to think that was all so long ago. I know, still, it was a bit of fun back then. Not all of it. True, but I mean, it all worked out in the end, didn't it? I mean, worked out for us. Yeah, I guess. Still, don't really want the old memories been dug up one more time. You feeling alright? Yeah, no, I'm okay. Just like, you know, you start telling stories again, just a lot of stuff sort of just like flashes back. Alright, yeah. I wasn't sure what you were on about, you know, the stuff that you didn't want to say to, you know, the guy there. Yeah, I don't want to let slip anything like that. Half that stuff still isn't common knowledge, dude. Hopefully it never will be. That's true. Actually, now that I think about it, do you remember the morning after? After what? The Strasbourg show. When we all went to bed after the session out by the lake. You fell asleep on the beach and we had to drag you back to the hotel.
Oh, yeah.
What about it? Remember I woke you up because I heard a car starting up downstairs. It was like, rent on-ish.
Yeah. Shit, I remember now. We got Violet out of her PJs and Alan out of bed and just got into the car. And those special three words... Bonus road trip.
Inside my head, there's a little place left for you. What do you know? What do you know? And all I want is to find out what you're going through. What do I know? Maybe the silence is dangerous.
Decker here.
You trying to sneak off before breakfast?
Lisa, how are you doing up so early?
Say anything about you, pal? You getting a bit attached to your new ride?
Maybe. It served us well. I'm taking it for one more spin.
Less spin? What are you talking about?
Keith? Of course you'd be there.
And that's not all. Rise and shine, world champion and future world champion.
Too early. Too hungover.
What he said.
But hey, what's this about one last ride?
Well, Decker here.
Morning, boss. Glad to see I wasn't the only one going for a Sunday drive.
Guess you couldn't resist, eh?
Well, of course. Especially seeing our golden boy here even stayed up to fix the car as good as new.
Golden boy?
Aye, gonna look. Trainee mechanic at your service. 6 month internship at old Ronnie's workshop. It's done me good there.
Holy shit, dude. Damn, is there anything that you can't do?
Apparently no. Still getting jobbed out.
Trader said it's gonna be changing real soon.
Yeah. Maybe the booker might have you wrestle as a panda more often.
Fuck that. Take any gimmick over that Morphe. Don't know how you manage it.
We'll let him know when he wakes up later after this little victory lap.
Yeah. And I was about to say, it's good that these cars are one last adventure. I'm getting retired.
You're tired. You're not going to the big parking lot in the sky, are they?
Something like that. These cars are nearly 10 years old. They're behind the times. So they're gonna strip the cars of any stuff they'll use again and sell them on to someone else.
So you're saying this is the last time these cars will be this awesome ever?
Sure, if you wanna think of it like that.
Shame you have to give the cars back then. Would have been nice to keep them.
Well, don't be so sure. I heard there's some pretty serious weather forecast for today again.
There is? First I've heard of it.
Yeah. Looking pretty terrible, Decker. In fact, it's already, could just be as bad as yesterday.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll be able to fly out with these forecasts I'm seeing.
Aye, dreadful stuff there. Like being back home.
Do we have any flights to catch today?
Actually, I haven't booked anything yet. It's gonna work it out after I gave this another spin. The weather is as terrible as you guys say it is.
Oh, it's terrible, Adam. Today, it's a complete write-off.
I don't think Stefan would mind if we are a little bit late back to Clone.
He seems like a cool guy.
Oh, cool guy?
I'm not your boss today in that case. I think it's your day off.
Nice one. You ready for a trip up North Lock?
Born ready, mate. Head back and pick up two lads.
Yeah, don't see why not. Youngblood's flying home anyway.
Annie, Alan, you up for a road trip?
Well, I'm already out of my PJs, so I guess.
Oh, where are we going?
Anywhere we want. Today, the road is ours. All I want is to find out what you're going through. What do I know? Maybe the silence is dangerous. I wanted to hide. We just want to find it. Feel what's inside. I wanted to come over. I Dekker here. Ah, how's it going, Lisa? Where have you guys ended up?
Hey, Adam. Yeah, we're in Tuscany at the minute. Got some nice country roads for the last while. The guys have just like kind of wander off to stretch their legs, and I think there's a vendor nearby selling some ice cream.
Real Italian gelato. Sounds nice. Glad you came along?
Yeah. I guess it was a bit of fun in the end.
Yeah, it was. You know, I'll be honest. I wasn't expecting you to join us for this tour. I thought you'd been full steam ahead for your move to Japan. But I appreciate you taking the time out for this. I mean that.
Decker. Adam. I didn't agree to do the tour for you. Or for anyone else on the roster, for that matter. I did this for Keith.
For Keith?
Like, he's dropping absolutely everything so he can fly halfway around the world with me. And, like, I actually can't express how much that means to me. Like, when he heard you guys were doing a tour before we got started, like, he was so excited. And I could tell how disappointed he was that he wasn't going to be able to do it. He just wanted to ride with the boys one last time. So, yeah, that's why I said yes.
I can understand that. I know I give him a hard time, but his heart's in the right place. And he thinks the world of you, so who am I to argue with that? As for the tour, well, I don't really care what your reasons were. It's good to have you here regardless. You're going to be missed.
I know I am. But I know that I have to go as well.
What do you mean?
I know this is best for my career, and I know I'm going to make stupid amounts of money and become really ridiculous household name and have my face plastered everywhere, but I don't know. I don't want to go anymore.
That's just cold feet talking. We've had this conversation before. Japan is a big change. You're bound to feel nervous before leaving.
Adam, this isn't nerves. I know what it's like. This is frustration. Frustration that it doesn't feel like my choice. Sure, I could tear up the contract and never leave, but I can't stay. I can't stay knowing what I know. There's a big part of me that really fucking regrets asking you for the truth on what happened that night. Like, I don't know what I was expecting, but like that. I'm so fucking mad at you.
Happened to lie?
For everything. It wasn't just you that this affected. Everyone on the roster that worked for Tony back then doesn't know about this. They were all friends with Lee too, you know. And Keith, do you have any idea how much that damaged him? Thinking there was an accident that was entirely his fault. Also, you could have a cover-up and everything just went on.
I didn't cover up anything. I was caught up in all of this just as much as anyone else, if not more so. Tony took matters into his own hands. I was completely out of control.
And that doesn't make you innocent, and you know it, Adam. This is going to get out eventually. It's just a matter of time. Is that why I'm going to Japan, so I won't be an issue for you anymore? Another person with the truth just disappears long enough for people to forget about it.
No, of course not. I told you before. I told you because you asked. And because I know, I can trust you with that. If I wanted to get rid of you, don't you think I'd have just fed you another lie? I've had to lie to people I call close friends for years about what happened. You are the only person I've told the truth to because you deserved to know. Don't think I've forgotten what happened to you that night as well. And how I wasn't able to stop it.
Alright, I've tried so hard to block out everything from that time, and just hearing all that back, it, like, everything is just opening up old wounds, Adam.
Please, we're both in the same boat here. We both have our own trauma. We're trying to rewrite history with new memories, but no matter how hard we try, we can't escape it.
Yeah, but there's one real big difference between you and me, though. I'm the victim, you're not. Or maybe you were and you just convinced yourself of guilt. I don't even know anymore. I've lost sleep thinking about this. How the fuck are you able to sleep at night after all this?
Usually, don't. I just keep myself distracted with this. I hope it eventually fades away. But until then, I'm gonna keep driving, keep running shows, live my life the way I want it to be. I know it's not gonna last.
Ain't that the truth?
I know you're pissed, Lisa. This business hurts a lot of people. That's why we need days like this. You can drive off and be a tourist. That's when going to rally across the Alps, or you'll be alone in your thoughts. These are the memories you want to keep. The ones that make all of this feel better. Wrestling will chew you up and spit you back out. But if you walk out with a fortune and a life you can live afterwards, then you've won. Simple as that. This is all I've ever known. And I'll never be able to leave. But you can. Japan wants you to be its next big thing. Let it be. And in time, you can come back and live the life that you want to.
I guess you're right. But Adam, I need you to promise me this.
Name it.
Don't call me again. Never. I can't work for you anymore knowing what I know. It doesn't feel right. And that's what hurts the most about this. Just knowing that all my friends are working for you and I may never be able to see them again for a long time. But yeah, right now this is the right thing for me to do.
Then you have my word. After this tour, me and you will have cut ties professionally. Anything happens to me, you won't be dragged into it.
Ties cut professionally and personally. Thanks, Adam. I really need to get that off my chest, and this has been the only time I've had to myself since the start of this tour.
I understand.
Right. Well, look, the guys are coming back now, so I guess we all have to head back too, huh?
Right, so. Flies at 10 p.m. It's been fun. We need to start making towns again.
Yeah, well, you know, whatever happens, Adam, good luck to you.
Same to you, Lisa. Kitu, umaku, ikuyo.